Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you to today's presentation sponsored by the Society of Decision Professionals, which is an SDP sponsor showcase webinar entitled Creating Value from Uncertainty and Flexibility.
Today we're going to talk about creating value from uncertainty and flexibility. The thinking and the methods I'm going to discuss today are general, not industry specific. But given that my background is oil and gas, and my examples will largely be oil and gas type examples. So there are basically two ways we can create value. We can create value by delivering on our promises, which is what I will address in the first half of the talk. And then we can also create value by focusing on trying to capture the upside of uncertainty. And we do that by implementing flexibilities and options. I want to start this off by showing you a histogram that was developed in a paper by Nandur Dikar, IPA, a few years back. IPA is a benchmarking company. They got more than 20,000 products in their database from more than 50 operators. The data we're looking at here covers about a 15-year span, starting around the year 2000. And what we're looking at here is the change in net present value. And the change is between the time the product was approved, the final investment decision estimate, and 2 years later. And as you will see here on the horizontal axis, this has been price normalized. So commodity prices, oil and gas prices, are not impacting this. If there is no change in the calculated net present value over this two-year period, then the bars will show up at 0% on this graph. The green bars are on the good side, so to speak, so then the change is a positive change, and the red bars are on the negative side, so then the change is a negative thing. And what Nandur Dikar is arguing in this paper is that we managed to destroy value on 75% of these projects. And the average of this histogram is about the negative 35%. So we seem to be struggling across all these products, which come from all over the world, to deliver on our promises. And what goes into that is typically, or the main drivers of that lack of ability to deliver on our promises, revolves around a lack of ability to deliver on time, to deliver on cost, and to deliver on early production or early benefit.